Jesus Christ's prophecy in Matthew 24 verse 2, Luke 21 verse 6, and Mark 13 verse 2. Do you see all these great buildings? Replied Jesus. Not one stone here will be left on another. Everyone will be torn down. All of the way church or believers had died, and the way was forgotten for 2,000 years or 2 days. In 2 Peter verse, chapter 3, verse 8, but do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like a day. Another sign of end-time prophecy of Jesus' return is the number 7 and 3. He had given the kingdom of earth to Satan for 6 days or 6,000 years to be the king of this wicked world. The seventh day is belong to Jesus, for he is the Lord of Sabbath, meaning he will return on the 7,000 years. He is the creation of Adam and Eve. Many prophecies foretold also that he will return on the third day since his first coming, the seventh since creation, and the third since the first advent fall in the same millennium years. In Luke 13, verse 31 to 32, at that time some Pharisees came to Jesus and said to him, leave this place and go somewhere else. Herod wants to kill you. He replied, go tell that fox, I'll drive out demons and heal people today and tomorrow, and on the third day I will reach my goal. In Luke 9, verse 22, and he said, the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders, chief priests, and teachers of the law, and he must be killed, and on the third day be raised to life. In Matthew 27:42-41, and saying, you who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. Come down from the cross if you are the Son of God. In the same way, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and elders mock him. And in John chapter 2, verse 18-23, then the Jews demanded of him, what miraculous sign can you show us to prove your authority to do all this? Jesus answered them, destroy this temple, and I will raise it again in 3 days. The Jews replied, it is taken 46 years to build this temple, and you are going to raise it in 3 days? But the temple he had spoken of was his body. The temple he had spoken of was his own body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples recalled what he had said. Then they believed the scripture and the words that Jesus had spoken. There is a dual prophecy here. First, Jesus' body was literally raised from the dead. He was resurrected on the third day. Second, the temple it is spoken of was his body, who is the temple of the Holy Spirit. The group of believers or the body of Christ is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And who is the one body of Christ? The way church of God or the church of Christ, Christ followers or the Christian members of the church called the way. In Isaiah 6:1-3, come, let us return to the Lord. He has torn us to pieces, but he will heal us. He has injured us, but he will bind up our wounds. After 2 days, after 2,000 years, he will revive us. On the third day, on the 3,000 years, he will restore us that we may live in his presence. Let us acknowledge the Lord. Let us press on to acknowledge him. As surely as the sun rises, he will appear. He will come to us like the winter rains, like the spring rains that water the earth. Now 2 days or 2,000 years had gone since his first coming. It was prophesied in Hosea that on the third day or on the 3,000 years, he will restore us, that we may live in his presence. It was prophesied also in Malachi, chapter 3, verse 1 to 2. See, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then suddenly, the Lord you are seeking will come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant whom you desire will come, says the Lord Almighty. The head of the way, Jesus Christ, will come to his temple, his body, or the way church. The head and the body will be reunited and alive. But who can endure the day of his coming in verse 2? Who can stand when he appears? For he'll be like a refiner's fire or a launderer's soap. Jesus did not use fire when he first came. He will rain fire and brimstone on his second coming. And in Malachi chapter 4, verse 1 to 3. Surely the day is coming. It will burn like a furnace. All the arrogant and every evil doer will be stubble. And that day that is coming will set them on fire, says the Lord Almighty. Not a root or a branch will be left to them. But for you who revere my name, the Son of Righteousness will rise with healing in his wings, and you will go out and leap like calves released from the stall. Then you will trample down the wicked. There will be ashes under the soles of your feet on the day when I do this thing, says the Lord Almighty. Isaiah's prophecy was fulfilled by John the Baptist, who revived and prepared the way also for Jesus' first coming. The Elijah to come that Israel anticipating but was missed because of their unbelief. Now a messenger that was chosen by God to revive and prepare the way church or ministry comes from the Gentiles, considered spiritual Israel, in fulfillment of the prophecies of Hosea, Malachi, and Isaiah, the way was revived in the Philippines. In Isaiah 24, verse 15, and verse 1 to 6, and 17 to 23. Verse 15, therefore, in the east, give glory to the Lord, exalt the name of the Lord, the God of Israel, in the islands of the sea or the Philippines. Verse 1, see, the Lord is going to lay waste the earth and devastate it. He will ruin its face and scatter its inhabitants. It will be the same for priest as for people, for master as for servant, for mistress or as for maid, for seller as for buyer, for borrowers as for lender, for debtor as for creditor. The earth will be completely laid waste and totally plundered. The Lord has spoken this word. The earth dries up and withers, the world languishes and withers, the exalted of the earth languish. The earth is defiled by its people. They disobeyed the laws, violated the statutes, and broken the everlasting covenant. Therefore, a curse consumes the earth. Its people must bear their guilt. Therefore, its inhabitants are burned up, and very few are left. Very few are left. Terror and pit and snare await you, O people of the earth. Whoever flees the sound of terror will fall into a pit. Whoever climbs out of the pit will be caught in a snare. The floodgates of the heavens are open. The foundations of the earth shake. The earth is broken up. The earth is split asunder. The earth is thoroughly shaken. The earth reels like a drunkard. It sways like a hut in the wind. So heavy upon it is the guilt of its rebellion that it falls never to rise again. In that day the Lord will punish the powers in the heavens above and the kings on the earth below. They'll be herded together like prisoners bound in a dungeon. They'll be shut up in prison and be punished after many days. The moon will be abased, the sun a shame. For the Lord Almighty will reign on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem and before its elders gloriously.